Suman Rao, and I'm blessed to be a neonatologist. A neonatologist is a pediatrician who cares for small babies. And I care for the smallest of the small. And indeed, I'm blessed to care for the 500 grammer and the 600 gram babies. And here, medical technology has really helped us. Our NICUs are now equipped with the best warmers, best incubators, and ventilators. And we are pushing the bar every day. You will see in papers that now a 300 gram baby is saved. Maybe a 250 gram baby is now doing well, but this is not enough. We need more. Medical technology and doctors are not enough. What is very important for the baby is something or someone who is important to all of us. What is the first word which comes to our mouth when we are in trouble, when we are in pain? Ma, exactly. Mother, mom. And our small babies are separated from their mothers for almost 2-3 months because they are in the NICU. So therefore, we need to humanize the interventions, and kangaroo mother care is one such intervention. Some of you all may heard about it. This is an intervention where a preemie is put skin-to-skin contact with a mother like you see here, and all the care, including respiratory support, ventilation, is provided on the mother's chest. And the NICUs, or the neonatal intensive care units, are now converted into the mother newborn intensive care unit. This is a very scientific intervention, because along with breastfeeding, this intervention improves survival by more than 40 to 50%. And that is why I'm here, to seek your support to help our preemies survive and grow. With medical technology, kangaroo mother care, and empowering the mother, we in our NICU are able to save a lot of small babies. And that is a very joyous occasion when our babies are ready to get discharged. And in fact, we call it a graduation. And any newborn who survived a neonatal unit is called an NICU graduate. But unfortunately, the perils of being a preemie doesn't end at the NICU door. Even after discharge, there are problems. I remember a 750 grammer whom, when we discharged at 3 months after a very stormy NICU course, the whole unit was in euphoria. We did it. And the parents, where the baby was conceived by artificial reproductive techniques, were on cloud nine because they had waited for this baby for 10 long years. A follow-up plan was made, but unfortunately, this baby came back to us in 2 weeks' time, not feeding well, not active, and struggling to take a breath. And that was heart-wrenching to see. Despite all this, we lost the baby, and we lost it due to this. And that many of you all may recognize as a virus. Some of you all may say it's the COVID virus. It is a virus, but it is not the COVID one which you all are familiar with. And today I would like to bring awareness of this virus, what we call the respiratory syncytial virus, or the RSV, which is a big killer among children, particularly infants and preemies. And the unfortunate story is that people are unaware about it. Medical fraternity is quite unaware about it. And that is why this discussion. So what is this RSV virus? As the name suggests, like COVID virus, it is a respiratory virus. So it may be a common cold when you and I get it, but in the preemies, it could mean death for the preemies. And today, we have the power to stop it. The statistics about RSV, which is increasing globally, are quite chilling. RSV is not a new virus. RSV has been there for decades, and the Western world knows about it. But in India, only now we are able to have the tools to diagnose RSV, and we realize that even in the low- and middle-income countries, it is a big problem. 6 to 10% of all deaths less than 6 months are due to this single pathogen. It's a most common pathogen after malaria that kills infants. And 95% of these deaths globally are in India and the low middle income countries. And unfortunately, the statistics and studies which have shown that it's not only the preemies, but in India, if you have one death due to RSV in the hospital, there are three more deaths in the community, and some of them may be perfectly normal babies. So we are only looking at the tip of the iceberg, and it's important, therefore, that we all come together to raise awareness about this particular infection. RSV, as I said, is not new. But what is new is that we are now on the threshold of getting medical drugs which can prevent RSV. India is now looking at this beacon of hope. And what is this? This is the immunoprophylaxis that is now coming into India. What do I mean by immunoprophylaxis? If I say vaccine, I think all of you all will understand very well, because each one of you I know has been vaccinated in the recent past, thanks to COVID. So in a vaccine, you put a part of a bug or an inactivated bug into your body, and your body develops the immunity towards it, so that next time when you get exposed to that bug, you have the soldiers to fight against it. But our small preemies, they can't mount this response. So you give them something ready-made, a ready-made immune antibodies, and that is immunoprophylaxis. So this is something that we should be aware of. And with this beacon of hope, we can reach out to the large majority of this high-risk population where immunoprophylaxis is indicated. It is not new. There are many guidelines from other countries where immunoprophylaxis is recommended for the small babies, like I talked about, who had a stormy in ICU course, who have some congenital heart defects, or who have some lung problems, or just plain immunodeficiency due to other conditions. Today, we have a tool to fight against it. Therefore, we need to look at what are the challenges then? Why haven't we heard about this virus that I'm talking about? The first thing is ignorance. And today, my job is to help you be aware of this. Education and parental guidance has been the single most important thing which has been shown as a best practice to fight RSV infection. Prevention is possible. You know, we wear a mask, our risk of infection is lower. So as a mother of a preemie, if you've taken your baby home, don't let anyone with a respiratory infection anywhere close to your baby. Our cultural, what we do, that we don't let a newborn baby go to functions, is very valid. We need to protect them. But despite all this, infection can occur. And therefore, we need to understand immunoprophylaxis. It's not you that we need to talk to alone. Unfortunately, the medical fraternity, the policy maker, also need to be made aware of. And there's a lot of momentum in the globally to improve on this. The cost is a big thing. I know the industry and globally, World Health Organization and other stakeholders are looking at how to make it within the reach, how to ensure that this immunoprophylaxis reaches the low middle income countries. In fact, on the horizon, there's a lot of advances which is happening. Just last year, we have a vaccine now, but that vaccine is only for the elderly immunocompromised, not for the newborn. There is a maternal vaccine which is coming out. But with all these advances, you and I can make the change now. You and I can increase awareness about this RSV infection for the preemies, because I'm sure in the audience, there are many who've had a friend who had a preemie, or they themselves may be mothers or grandfathers and grandmothers of preemies. It is important to be aware of it. This is not just a dream. Yes, you have a dream and you'll have a manifestation. But this dream is, we can do it today. This immunoprophylaxis is within our reach and we can reach out to our babies. So what I would like to request you to join hands with us, be aware of this, be aware of the infection, be aware of the immunoprophylaxis, be aware of behavioral interventions like kangaroo mother care and breastfeeding, through which we can ensure that every vulnerable preemie gets these life-saving tools. And this, we know when we save a baby's life, it's a life full of potential, a life that can survive, thrive, and transform the world. So in conclusion, I would like to invite you to join us in this mission and with the vision of India Newborn Action Plan, which you see here. The government is committed to it. We, the medical fraternity, are committed to it, where the vision is a world where there are no preventable deaths of newborns or children. We do everything for the citizens. We do everything where every pregnancy is wanted and where every birth is celebrated. And when the women, babies, and children survive, thrive, and reach their full potential. An RSV-free world. A baby reaches a potential, and you and I together can do it. Let that be our promise, and thank you very much.